Hola amigos, this is Somvil and welcome to CodePipe. In the last video we have seen how to set up colors and how to set up fonts and where to get these color combinations and fonts from the internet. We have set up our mood board. So in this video we will see how we can design high fidelity of a website. So let's get directly into it. But before that, let me show you what we are trying to achieve. So this is the page that I have designed already. We will try to replicate this. So let's get started. I will be using the same artboard that I have used as a wireframe we have created in a couple of videos back. So let me just grab it, hit Alt, copy this. But again, I will always recommend that we make a wireframe in different file and high fidelity in different. I will rename it to homepage HF, meaning high fidelity. Here I will delete all of this for once because I will be making the graphics for the background. For that I will be taking a rectangle, a big one. I will be filling it with the color, and this time we are not going to fill it with a solid color, so we can also use linear gradient from here. First color I want is this one and second color I want is yellow. And we can adjust our gradient as per our requirement. So I am happy with this. As I have told you, we can add colors to our palette and document asset. So I will use the add button. Once we have created the gradient, and we may want to use it for another thing also. So I will click on it, go to document assets. I will use the plus icon to add the color. So if I say add, it will show the gradient of the color. Okay, now I will take a circle, press shift so that it is a circle, not an ellipse. Taking it in the center, increasing the size. Now we can resize it to a bigger circle so that it will cover the complete page. Keep it in center. Once we think we have the desired shape, we can select the circle. Using shift, we will select the rectangle. And I will use this tool which says subtract. So it will subtract this circle from the rectangle. If I do this, I'm only left with this small abstract looking shape on the top. I will press Alt, take it down, rotate it 180 degrees. And here I have the top and bottom of my website. I will put it down. And also I can select both of them, make a component out of it. Using Ctrl K, we have our component here, so let's name it background. If we want, we can also change the shape of this like this. Our background is ready, so we will include the header. Now we will be seeing one advantage of using components. So we have drawn this in our wireframe section, but I can use it here also if I keep it here. Now here it is. With some changes we will be able to make it good looking. So starting from the top, I want this rectangle to be blackish in color, so I will use this one. Now I will make all this text with filling white. We have some divider here. I will also fill them with white. For this rectangle I will not keep the borders, and for the fill I will also remove the fill so that we are having the background on the top, or we can see the background. I will give a color to the logo, which will be, let's say, this one. I want these to be in white. This rectangle is okay. I want to give this different color. Let's say I want to give it this one. These two things looks okay now. For this navigation bar, I will again give a color of blackish, this one. The text is already in white, so it is okay. Now one thing I want to add here is, I want to add a rectangle here that will indicate which is the page that we are on. So I will make a rectangle on this, and this rectangle I will send it to backward. So I can always use this arrange, and if you see, to send it forward we can use the control plus open bracket, open square bracket. So I'm going to use the open square bracket method. Now rectangle and text both are of the white color, so I will make this home different color, let's say orange, and I will make the rectangle yellowish in color. Okay, this looks good. I will remove the border from this. Now I forgot to include one thing here, So let me just quickly make a change here. I will copy this, make it checkout. I will bring back the rectangle on home. By the way, this checkout button is for directly checking out whatever we have in the cart. So user will not have to go through cart and then go for checkout. If we click on checkout, it will directly check out the items that are available in the cart. Now I want to make a shape here so that our cart and price and wishlist are coming on the top as evident. So I will take a rectangle. Let me show you a cool feature with rectangle and pen tool. This is a rectangle. If I double click on it, we will get these 4 points and we can use this to reshape our rectangle. Now if we see, if we hover on the line, we can see we have the pen tool using which we can add any point here, and this point will take it upwards. If we double click on the points, it will make it circular in shape. So we are going to do that. Or if we want to delete a point, we can just use delete, add another point, drag it downwards, and we can use these extensions to give the circular area larger radius like this. I think this looks okay. I will remove the border, fill it with yellow. Now I want this shape to be behind the text and above the header. So I will select the header, ungroup it using Ctrl Shift G. Now I will send it backward using Ctrl open bracket. Now this color bar is also on the top. So I will ungroup this also. Use this rectangle, send it backward to a point where it is just below the shape. Now we are good to go. We have what we want. If we want, we can again make a group out of all of this so that we can use it for further. So let me just do it. For that, I will first lock this so that it doesn't move when I select something. And then if I select these things, make it a group or component. We can see component is added, so we can say HF header. Also, we can make a component out of this shape. Let's say component, we can call it header splash so that it will be easy to export to developers, and also if we want to use it somewhere else, it will be easy. Now let me quickly copy paste the wireframe here so that I can have a easy reference. I will copy this, take it here. Okay, so now we need to make a hero section. So as we have already made a group out of this, so I will hold alt and bring it here. Now let's bring back our layout using Ctrl Shift and inverted commas. This is in the container. I will bring it up a little bit. I will increase the height of this to 540 so that our images will be easily available and shown. This looks okay. We will deal with the shop button. Let's delete the deal of the day for now, this image. Now I want to show a cool thing while dealing with images. So if we want to put an image here, let's go to our folder where we have kept all our images. So this is the folder where I have kept all my images. So I will minimize it and I will just drag and drop what image I want. So for the hero section, I want this image. So I will drag it here. And if you see, we are all getting an option of copy. So if I just place it here, we have our image inside the rectangle. Let's change the color of this to yellow maybe. Okay, this to yellow. For the shop now button, what we can do is, first of all, let's bring it here, make them a group. Now we will change the rectangle. If we double click on it, we will get the pen tools. So I will click here, bend it. I will try to give it a simple circular shape. Okay, I think this will work for me. I will make it a component with the name button splash. Change the color to yellow so that it matches with the constant theme. If we want, we can change the color of this text. So let me go to my character styles and let's keep it 16. Let's make it underline. But again, I'm doing it for the sake of explanation, but I suggest you give a thought of what colors you are using and what do you want to achieve. Now I also want a shape here that will say offer or discount. So I will use a rectangle. Double click on it. Double click, double click, double click, double click. I will make a point here, 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 and here. I will bring them in. Once I'm happy this, I can make a component out of it. Let's say offer splash, removing borders, filling it with again yellow color, saying splash offer, or let's say 20% off center. I will select this rectangle. But if you have made a group, don't forget to double tap on the rectangle so that you are inside the group and selecting the rectangle. We just want to select the rectangle, not everything. Removing the border, I will give it a shadow. For the shadow, I will give, let's say, x5, y5, let's say keep it 10. But if you want to see it, we can select this and use this play icon. It will open us a new window, make it full screen. We can see how it will look on the main web page. This looks good to me. Close it. So sorry guys, during editing I came to know that rest of the video is corrupted. So let me quickly give you a walkthrough of the process that I did. First of all, I copied everything from the wireframe into this. Then I changed the fonts by clicking here, going to our assets and selecting appropriate style. In the item card also, I have changed the text, inserted one image, same as we have inserted into this offer section. I have removed the border line and I have given some shadow. We took a rectangle on top of it, and like we created the splash icon, we have created this using pen tool. We made a random shape, decreased the transparency using this fill. On this side, we will have the transparency option. Then I have sent the shape backwards so that it is in the background. Basically, I have done the same thing with this items from your wishlist. I just copied this section and changed the shape of this background image. In the next section, that is for him, I use the same technique. I copied this from the wireframe. For this image, I have already removed the background using internet. Then I made a shape, random shape, sent it to the background. Then I used the offer splash and used it just behind the text so that it is visible. And basically I'm using the same cards on everywhere. Then I copied the special offer image from the wireframe. Then I copied the for him section to make some changes so that it is for her section. In the last section, we have from the blog, copied the section from wireframe, inserted some images, changed the character styles, and we are good to go. At the last, I copy pasted the footer using our assets. Here we can see we have the footer. I copy pasted, made it transparent so that I am only able to see text that is in white color. Then I copied the icon that is on the top, rotated it and sent it backward. So this is the process. Again, I am so sorry that the video was corrupted, but in a moment I will show you how my complete website will look like, so you will have a good idea about the website. So we can see this is how our website will look like. And we can check here and we can make some changes if we want. And again, for time constraint, we are not able to design all the pages, but this is the basic process how we can do this. Now let me quickly show you what I have designed. So this is my design. First of all, I took the mood board. I used some colors and fonts at the beginning, and I have added orange ones after I have started designing, but we can always add them at the first. Then this is my pages. So let me show you what all I have. So if I preview this, so we can see we have a similar kind of page that we have designed. Then if we use the right arrow, it will get us to the next page. So this is my category page, where we will have sort option, filters on the left, we have products. And if you observe, I have used some sale buttons to inform that this is on sale. Then we have product page, where we'll have all these options from the wireframe. I have added some colors. Then we have wishlist, our order review page, our sign up page, sign in page, our my account page. Then we have all orders page from the account. Then we have order summary for an individual product or individual order. Then we have contact us page. Then we have legal info page about the policies and terms of use. Then we have seller dashboard. So this is how our seller dashboard will look like. I'm not making it very attractive because this is just a dashboard and we just want information here. But if you want, we can add all sort of options and colors here. This is our inventory. I have added all category field here. Then we have minimum inventory, all inventory. If we click on it, we will get to this page where we will have all the items with us. And I have used this button here to identify only two items are left or three items are left. Then we have order page or order management page where we can see recent orders and returns or refunds, all the orders info, single order info, where if the order is already delivered, we can accept or deny the refund or whatever the process we want. Since we are not including the delivery process here or the tracking option here because different sellers will have different types of delivery, so not including that in this. So this is what my website looks like after making a high fidelity design, and I believe this is a good point to stop the video here. In the next video, we will see how to make mobile versions of the website, and after that we will see how to make prototypes. So better stay tuned, and if you have not subscribed to the channel, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to push the notification bell. Hit a like if you like the video. Let me know any comments in the comment section. Share the video with your friends. And don't forget to follow us on social media handles and support us on Patreon. We will meet very soon with a new video. Until then, this is Somvir taking your leave. Adios.